San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora files his certificate of candidacy for re-election in the 2022 polls. ABS-CBN correspondent Vivian Bulla now joins us with the latest. Viv, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. San Juan Mayor Francis Zamora has officially sought re-election as he filed his certificate of candidacy for the 2022 polls this morning. Should he win, Zamora says public health will remain a priority and all effort will be exerted in battling COVID-19 towards economic recovery. Zamora cited as part of his accomplishments the COVID vaccination in San Juan, which was the first city to inoculate 70% of its population, the initial target for herd immunity in the country. In 2019, Zamora's victory against Janela Estrada ended the 26-year uninterrupted hold of the Estradas to San Juan's top post. This 2022, it remains to be seen who among the Estrada clan will go up against the incumbent mayor. But Zamora says he is optimistic his service was felt during his first term as mayor. His running mate, Vice Mayor Warren Villa, also filed COC for re-election, along with aspirants for San Juan City Council seats. These include PBA star and two-time MVP James Yap, who said he wants his story to influence the youth and inspire them to get into sports. But Yap says he isn't retiring back his career in basketball just yet. Former PBA players Don Aliado and Paul Arsadi, actor and former basketball player Irvic Bihandre and Maki Mathai, are also part of Zamora's lineup for city councilors. Other council aspirants in Zamora's ticket are Angelo Agcawili, Ryan D., Raisa Laurel, Totoy Bernardo, Bea de Guzman, Kit Peralta, and Franco Yam. Before the COC filing, Zamora and his ticket attended a Thanksgiving Mass at Pinaglabanan Church, where several supporters wearing red shirts were waiting. But physical distancing was observed inside the church. At the local COMELEC office, the light rain did not stop supporters from staging a festive welcome for Zamora's team. There were drums playing on the background and supporters carrying posters cheering on. That's despite a previous appeal from the Philippine National Police to avoid fiesta-like COC filing, which could be a potential COVID super spreader. Zamora had also earlier advised supporters to just watch the COC filing via FB Live, but he says some still showed up. Policemen were on site to enforce physical distancing and minimum health protocols like wearing face masks. That's the latest from here. Carmina, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Viv. Take care. Keep safe.